Hello, in this video, I will take you through the settings of the Yoast Video SEO add-on. But first, let me tell you what this add-on does. It helps search engines find your videos and display them in a rich result format. It does that by adding schema markup to your pages and by creating an XML video sitemap. As a result, your video content becomes more visible and hopefully your rankings improve. So let's see how the plugin works. To access the plugin settings, go to SEO, then Video SEO. On this screen, you can adjust all the settings of the plugin. We start with the general settings. The first thing you can do here is to view your XML video sitemap. Just click on the link here, and a new tab with the XML video sitemap will open. You can see the video's title, thumbnail, description, category, and duration in the sitemap. You can also click on the titles, which will take you to the page the video is posted on. Now let's discuss the XML video sitemap for a second. The first thing that's important to mention is that you must enable the XML sitemaps in the Yoast SEO plugin before using the Video SEO plugin. XML sitemaps are enabled by default in Yoast SEO, so you won't need to do anything in most cases. But if for some reason you disabled them, this is what you'll need to do. Go to the SEO admin menu item, then click on General, and then Features. In this list, we see the XML sitemap setting. And all we need to do is switch the toggle on. In my case, it's already on, so I don't have to do anything. Now back to the Video SEO screen. Let's see. By ticking this box, you can hide the XML video sitemap from normal visitors. Why would you do that? Because sitemaps are generally public, and people can find them in the source code, for example. That may give your competitors an insight into your site structure, which perhaps you do not want to share. So, if you want to hide the XML video sitemap, you can tick this box. The setting below, Disable Media RSS Enhancement, is specifically developed for the edge cases where an RSS feed would stop working when the video add-on is enabled. This is an issue we've built a manual fix for, just for the people with this problem. We've implemented a setting you can simply turn off, and it'll make sure your RSS and podcast will keep working. Custom fields are a feature in WordPress that lets you add additional metadata to your posts. If you use custom fields on your site, and if they contain any videos, the plugin will scan them for video content. To do that, you'll need to manually add the custom fields to the Video SEO plugin settings. In the post linked in the description, we explain how that works. This next setting is optional. The Video SEO plugin supports most video services. Check the link in the description of this video to see the list of platforms the plugin supports. However, if you're using a video service that the plugin doesn't support, you may need to insert an API key here. If you want to use this option, you'll need to sign up for a free Embedly account and provide the API key you receive. Then the plugin will try to receive enriched video information using Embedly. So what's next? It's the embed settings. The first thing you can do in this section is to enable videos to play on Facebook and Twitter. So as the setting says, if the video gets shared on another website or social media, people will still be able to play it. The next setting is about making your videos responsive with fitvids.js. What does that mean? It means that if you're using fitvids.js, Yoast Video SEO, together with fitvids.js, will make the size of your videos adjust to your theme and your web design. The input field below lets you manually add the default width of your video embeds. By default, the plugin will use the content width of your theme. If the field is empty, you can manually set the desired value. That will then be the default width for your embedded videos. Finally, if you use Wistia in combination with a custom domain, add the custom domain here. For example, you can insert yourdomainname.wistia.com. In the next two sections, you can customize the plugin so it only scans the parts of your website that contain videos. If you only have videos in your posts, tick the box next to Posts. The same goes for taxonomies. Do you have any videos in your category or tag pages? Then tick the box next to them. if you have an e-commerce website, you'll also see additional options here. For example, there will be a product box or product categories and product tag boxes you'll be able to tick. The final option on this screen is about indexing. You may need to re-index your videos to update metadata or check old content for new features in some cases. By default, a re-index only scans the content that hasn't been indexed. However, if you check Force Re-index of already indexed videos, you can force the plugin to rescan everything. Okay, now you have the basic settings for the video XML sitemaps covered. What about using the plugin? Let's see how that works. I'll go to the post editor because in this case I embed videos in my posts. So let's open one of the posts. Here you can see that I already embedded a video. Now I can customize the video in the Video tab of the Yoast SEO meta box. Before we look at the settings, let's talk about schema for a bit. So far, in the Video SEO settings, we focused on the XML sitemap. But another great thing the Video SEO add-on does is add specific video schema on your pages containing videos. Both the XML Video Sitemap and the schema markup help search engines understand that the page includes a video, and they can display it better in the search results. Okay, now let's take a look at the settings in the meta box. The first thing you can do is disable the video. This feature removes the video from the XML Video Sitemap. It also removes the schema that the Video SEO plugin produces on the page. However, the post or page will still appear on the post or page sitemap, and Yoast SEO will still output its default schema. If you want to keep the video, you can move on. With the video thumbnail setting, you can choose an image that Google will display in a Google video search. If you don't add a custom thumbnail, the plugin will use the still shot of the first video frame for it. To set the thumbnail, all you need to do is click the Upload button. Then select an image, either from your computer or from the media library, like this. With the video duration setting, you can describe how long the video is. The plugin will add this information to the schema output as well as the XML sitemap. If you don't add the time, Video SEO will attempt to calculate it. In the next two settings, you can add categories and tags for the video. They'll appear in the XML Video Sitemap, so search engines can better understand the video's content. If you don't add any tag here, and if your post contains no tags, then the Video SEO plugin will automatically use your post's focus keyphrase as a tag in the XML Video Sitemap. If you do add tags, the plugin will still add the focus keyphrase alongside them. When it comes to categories, the plugin will output only one category in the sitemap. If you don't add a category, the plugin will not use the key phrase for the category as well. If you have a category for the post, but you add a new category for the video in this field, then the video category will override the post category. That means that the Video SEO plugin will display the video category in the XML Video Sitemap. You can also set a rating for the video that will become part of the video sitemap. Finally, the last setting in the meta box is Mark if not family friendly. If you tick this box, the video will be hidden for searches that use Google's Safe Search. It is outputted as an item property for Video Object Schema and also in the sitemap. By default, we leave the box unchecked. Now, if I go back to check the sitemap, I see it also includes titles and descriptions. But there is no description to add in the Video SEO meta box, so how does that work? Well, the plugin uses the meta description you add to the post, and then adds it to the sitemap and the schema output. When you use Yoast SEO, you can add the meta description by clicking on the Google Preview tab in the Yoast SEO sidebar, right here. If you don't add any meta description, Video SEO will use the first couple lines of the post as the description. The title of the video that you see in the sitemap is pulled from the SEO title. You can edit the SEO title in the Google Preview tab as well. And that's it! Now you know all the features and settings of the Video SEO add-on. You can start embedding your videos and customizing them to your needs. Have fun!